بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Our case today is baby preterm, 29 weeks, extremely breast weight, 900 grams. Actually admitted with RDS, severe RDS. He received one dose of surfactant, and still the oxygen requirement was more than 35, and mean airway pressure it was more than 7 centimeter Rotor. So the second dose of surfactant given. And the baby was in conventional mechanical ventilation. Then we shift him to high frequency. It was a stormy course. Then after that, the baby is successfully weaned from high frequency to conventional, and successfully we put him in non-invasive. If you go here, this is non-invasive, it's spontaneous CPAP. But unfortunately, the last 2 days, the baby start to have apnea. So this baby start to have apnea and associated with bradycardia, circulatory insufficiency, and the saturation. Call it ABCs, we call it ABCs. A, apnea, and B, it's bradycardia, and C, circulatory insufficiency, and D is desaturation. Call it ABCs. So the baby developed apnea associated with bradycardia and circulatory insufficiency and desaturation. So our interaction with this apnea in two ways, general measures and specific measures. So we did for this patient actually the general measures. The first thing you have to do it, this is baby apneic, ABC, airway, breathing, and circulation. So the ABC, the airway, you have to maintain the airway, and you have to open the airway, and you have to clear the secretions, and also you have to monitor the airway and manage the airway. 3M, maintain airway, monitor the airway, manage the airway. So maintain the airway, you have to positioning the baby, you have to put the baby in the sniffing position, not flexion, otherwise we'll block the airway, it will be associated with obstructive apnea, and also it no hyper extension, it will be semi extension to keep the airway open. This is the first action. Then if there is any secretion, you have to clear it, you have to clear the secretion, but don't gentle suction, don't go deep, otherwise it will lead to vasovagal attack and the baby having bradycardia. It will having bradycardia. It's okay. And also, if the baby is in feet, you have to hold the feet for 24 hours. This is the general measures. And also, you have to do for him tactile stimulation. Tactile stimulation, the baby, most of or the majority of the apnea prematurity, it will respond to tactile stimulations. If the baby is not response to tactile stimulation, you have to give oxygenation. So you have to give oxygenation. This oxygenation, actually by any means, by free flow oxygen or by what's it called, this nasal cannula or high flow nasal cannula, you have to give oxygen. If the baby is not respond to tactile stimulation and oxygenation, and you have to give bag mask ventilation. Bag mask ventilation. If the baby is not respond to bag mask ventilation, immediately you have to put him in positive pressure ventilation. In the positive pressure ventilation, this is called now we in the specific measure. Specific measure. Before that, you can also start caffeine or methylxanthines. If the baby is in caffeine, he's in caffeine actually, we increase it by 20%. And if he's not in caffeine, you have to load him with caffeine. Then after that, non-pharmacological measures, it will be the non-invasive mechanical ventilation. We'll try with him non-invasive mechanical ventilation. The baby actually, if you come closer here, actually he's in spontaneous CPAP, FI oxygen 21, and BEEB 6 actually, and inspire time is 0.4. So he's in non-invasive CPAP. So we will shift him to intermittent positive pressure ventilation. We call it non-invasive conventional mechanical ventilation. Here, this is the spontaneous CPAP. So we go for BC, pressure control. We call it CMV. This is mandatory ventilation. So we'll go here. Actually, we'll check the setting, because this is intermittent positive pressure ventilation. This is non-invasive. What is the meaning of non-invasive? This is you give respiratory support without ETT, without ETT, just only nasal intermittent positive pressure ventilation. Nasal intermittent, if you see here, this is nasal intermittent positive pressure ventilation. So we'll put him in conventional mechanical ventilation, but nasal, not invasive. So the setting, it will be same. It will be same. So I will set the beep. Beep is 6, and the BIB is 15, and the inspiratory time will keep 0.4 here. We'll put him in BC continuous mandatory ventilations. So beep 6 and the BIB 15, and the inspiratory time will increase a little bit. Because it's non-invasive, you can increase it a little bit. And rate, we put rate 40. We put rate, this is called non-invasive ventilation or nasal intermittent positive pressure ventilation. So after we put the setting, you have to confirm immediately. Otherwise, if you will not confirm within 20 minutes, he will close the screen. This is one of the way how to compensate the apnea of the prematurity. You have general measures, you have to positioning and clear the airway, maintain the airway, monitor by pulse oximeter or cardiorespiratory, and you have to give tactile stimulation and oxygenation. After that, if the baby is not improved, you can give bad mask ventilations, and if the patient give pharmacological management of methylxanthines, and after that, if not improved, you have to put in positive pressure ventilations. Then the best, it will be non-invasive intermittent positive pressure ventilation or nasal, call it nasal intermittent positive pressure ventilation. This is what we did here. We put him in BC CMV, we call it nasal intermittent positive pressure ventilation to compensate the apnea. After we did the general measures and we increased the caffeine 20%, and we shift him from CPAP to nasal non-invasive mechanical ventilation, like the conventional mechanical continuous mechanical ventilations. So the baby is apnea is settled, and even you see here the saturation is maintained, heart rate is maintained, and even the baby it's comfortable and no more apnea with this setting. At the end, I would like to pray for my colleagues going for study board, journey board, and fellowship. And I would like to thank our staff to give us the chance for delivering this educational activity.